Have you personally, I don't know if you're comfortable answering this question, tried these drugs?
I haven't.
Neither one of you have.
No.
So it's all based on anecdotal.
Well, it's not anecdotal. Maybe 20, 30 patients a week sometimes come in here with talking about the medicine.
Their effects. The girlfriends or the wives of people taking it, do they ever complain that now their husband, who was fine with once or twice a month, is now wanting it every night?
That has happened. I mean, you know, the wives have said, you know,
stop writing those prescriptions.
You know, and you know, kind of kidding. You know,
but
why
not?
So yeah, there is, I think.
So there's an adjustment for relationships,
right,
that they.
I think in the couples in their 60s or over.
Well, because the woman is not necessarily taking anything to make her. They don't have like a female version of Viagra, right? Or do they?
Not yet.
They've been working on it.
Okay, so there's hope for us women out there.
Women get older and they're postmenopausal or they're perimenopausal and they have
dryness and
dryness, and that poses an issue as well. And so
because now this guy is going for 45 minutes, he's just like, enough already.
Sometimes you'll have a man come in and he's talking about taking the pill so that he can have better erections. And then the question comes up, well, what does your wife think? Or what does your spouse think? So what does your significant other think?
And they're like,
and the answer is, you know, after they go home and they talk it over, that they don't really want it.
And of course, you know, there's the men that want it psychologically and really don't use it afterwards, but they want it available just in case they need it. You know, and a male ego thing, that it's still important in society, it's still important to have sex, but yet they don't go there, but they have it if they need it.
There's so many psychological issues associated with not being able to get an erection. So do you find yourself doing a lot of psychological counseling as well? Or?
Absolutely. I think people understand that it's not unusual. There are physical reasons, there's emotional reasons, and that they're not necessarily, they're not the only ones.
You find that it becomes like a self-fulfilling prophecy, that they have difficulty one time and get an erection, and then psychologically they think, you know, it may affect them the second time, and then it gets to be a cycle.
More than 50% of it.
That's like the whole performance
anxiety.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it can happen with younger men as well as older men.
Yes.
It happens a lot.
Younger guys who actually have some performance anxiety,
yeah.
Usually what will happen is they'll come in, they need to have the medication for a little while, and then they come back and they're like, well, I'm okay now.
That's something for viewers to hear, that you could try it for a little while. You won't become addicted to the Viagra medication.
No, it's not addictive in the physical sense.
Psychologically, you might think you need it more for like a crutch.
Yes.
And then you wean yourself off of it and you're fine.
Yes.
And also with certain partners.
A particular partner
puts an awful lot of focus on it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it will definitely create more anxiety.
Does the variety of partners have an impact on the ability to get an erection? Someone's been married for, 20 years to the same partner, then they get divorced. The same guy who might have been having a hard time getting an erection for 20 years now is out with several different women and he has no problem getting an erection. We call that the Coolidge effect. Have you found that to be the case?
Personally?
Well,
I think there is an effect to that.
It can enhance
the ability with a new partner or new surroundings.
But you're really talking about the whole psychological evolution of a marriage from courtship to romantic love to years of marriage and children, and then the devolution of that relationship, which is just a whole separate subject.
Right.
Really.
Yes, I am talking about that.
That's for the next. You know.
Is there anything else that you could share with us?
Bottom line is that there's a lot of stuff out there now that can be done.
To help this?
Yes, to help that. So nobody should be thinking that there's nothing that can be done and they should seek help.
You two came on this show just to make awareness of what these topics are like. So if you'd like to see Dr. Joel or Dr. Sam, look in the comment section below, and the website will be there as well. Please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to comment and like it. Let me know if there's anything that you want me to discuss, because there's nothing that I won't discuss. Bye-bye, and keep spreading the love encore. Mwah.